Remember the Monster Hunter collaboration that never happened? Look, guys, here it is! Maeve's Trustmaster reward is a set of heavy armor with high levels of defense and spirit. Not only that, but its passive also adds on additional HP and boosts earth and dark resistance by 30%. It's a very nice set, well-suited for a Neovision unit's Trustmaster reward. Her Super Trustmaster reward is a one-handed hammer. Its attack is low, but that's because you should be paying attention to its tremendous defensive stats instead. It, too, has another passive, though this one boosts equipment defense and spirit so long as this hammer is the only weapon being held. This means you can also hold a shield for additional defensive stats without taking any penalties. Onto her active abilities. Practice Lure's Active Provoke gives Maeve a 75% general damage mitigation buff and a whopping 65% physical and magical mitigation buff against beast and dragon enemies. Effective strategy will grant your team resistance to all status ailments, breaks, stop, charm, and throw on a 50% general mitigation buff as well. Oddly, despite having a provoke symbol, it does nothing of the sort. Feral Instinct lowers the enemy's earth resistance by 130%, imbues earth onto your team, and then boosts their earth damage by 30%. Hunting Call raises the morale gauge. Natural Protection removes any cover effects on Maeve, activates a strong physical cover, grants Maeve a 65% physical mitigation buff, and an additional 65% physical mitigation buff against beasts and dragons. Run Wild boosts your team's stats by 280%, raises their earth resistance by 100%, and then boosts their Limit Burst gauge fill rate by 200%. Practice Swing inflicts a 25% hammer imperil. Use defense-based physical damage that scales with morale, fills your team's limit burst gauges by a decent amount with each use, and chains a floating strike. Wild Guard boosts your team's defense by 200%, gives them a 50% physical mitigation buff, and lets them evade 5 attacks. Passives. But for Trustmaster reward or Super Trustmaster reward equipped, she gains resistance to stop, resistance to select ailments for more resistance overall, additional equipment defense when carrying a single weapon, and the automatic ability that dispels any cover buffs and then activates a weak physical cover. She deals increased damage to beasts and dragons, and has a whopping 50% boost to both types of evasion. She prefers to carry a single weapon, and also meets half the boosted chain limit cap. During Clash of Wills, she gets access to certain abilities depending on the morale gauge. Below 80%, she gets Never Fear, which steals any breaks and status ailments from your team, and places them on herself. And while this is pretty debilitating for a tank, it also dispels her right after. When the morale gauge is higher than 120%, she has access to Yorin Natural, which grants your team a powerful double beast and dragon killer, and gives them a 50% physical and magical mitigation buff against beast and dragon enemies. If your morale gauge is lower than 50% and you somehow haven't lost yet, she's got Need Assistance, a one-use-only ability which lets Maeve absorb earth attacks, grants her a 90% general damage mitigation buff, and activates the strongest ultra cover you've ever seen, protecting your team from all types of attacks. At EX plus 2, she gets an instant limit burst. At EX plus 3, she gets 500 defense. Let's look at her limit burst. It's a single blow that deals physical damage that scales off her defense and gets stronger with morale, boosts your team's defense by 350%, and lets them evade 5 attacks. Time to change forms. Maeve has a true Brave Shift, which has no limitations whatsoever. Onto her active abilities. Natural Wall is natural protection, but switches its goal from physical defense to magical defense. Limitless Ferocity fills your team's limit burst gauges by a decent amount, boosts their limit burst damage by 100%, and boosts their limit burst gauge fill rate by 200%. Gifted Swing inflicts a 25% hammer imperil, and then deals magical earth damage that scales off your spirit, boosts your team's limit burst gauges by a decent amount of each use, and chains a floating strike. Wild Barrier boosts your team's spirit by 300%, gives them a 50% magical mitigation buff, and the HP barrier that actually scales with morale, possibly scaling up to a maximum of 19,000 bonus HP. Passives. But for Trustmaster reward or Super Trustmaster reward equipped, she gets a 50% boost to her earth resistance, additional equipment spirit when carrying a single weapon, and the automatic ability that dispels any cover buffs, and activates a weak magical cover. Everything else is pretty much the same, but you have to note that she has less status ailment resistance in this form. Additionally, when she reaches EX plus 3, the stat buff is changed from defense to spirit. Let's look at her limit burst. It's another single blow, but it deals magic damage which scales off her spirit stat, and this time, it's imbued with earth. It also buffs your team's spirit by 350%, and then throws on an even greater HP barrier that scales with morale, which can reach a level of 25,000 additional health. That might even be double the health of some units in your team. Let's rank Brave abilities. I'd prioritize Natural Protection for a stronger cover buff, Natural Wall for a stronger cover buff, and practice lure for more niche mitigation levels. Time to make a damage rotation. On turn 1, cast Feral Instinct, Wild Guard, and Run Wild. On turns 2 to 5, triple cast Practice Swing. If her Limit Burst is ready anytime throughout this rotation, use that to cap a chain instead. Then you repeat the rotation from here. Given Maeve's high Limit Burst costs, it's overall better to boost her Limit Burst gauge fill rate in the hopes of firing it off more often. If you wish to use her as a magic damage dealer, the nature of the rotation should be the same. So, EX2? At EX plus 2, she gets an instant Limit Burst. Given that Maeve has no innate booster Limit Burst gauge fill rate, she'll really appreciate this, given the high cost of her Limit Burst. Sure, she does have a 200% Limit Burst gauge fill rate buff for her team, but she's still at a baseline of nothing without it. Her base form's Limit Burst has 5 evasion stacks, while her Brave Shift has a chunky HP barrier, though its chunky level depends on your morale, and it may take your time to really raise her spirit in battle. At EX plus 3, Maeve gains more defensive stats. This definitely ups her sturdiness, though you'll often worry about elemental resistance more anyways, even without taking EX plus 3's cost into account. So how good is Maeve? As a tank, she's incredibly sturdy, both as a physical tank and a magical tank. Her true Brave Shift really helps matters, letting her flip between rows of ease, and with a skill set that dispels any cover buffs, she's ready to go at a moment's notice. Now, it's true that the thought of switching tank types mid-fight is unorthodox, but so long as you choose to ignore that detail, you'll find that Maeve is still a perfectly strong unit in both rows as a more conventional tank. Her support buffs are incredibly solid, with stat buffs, resistance buffs, and buffs for her team's Limit Burst. She's also a surprisingly good Earth supporter too, with an Imbue, Impero, and an Amplification buff packed into one ability. There are some things she's missing, Passive Provoke for one, but she also has strong Active Provoke buffs anyways, though of course it might be a problem if the opponent likes to spam with a spell. She also lacks elemental resistance coverage aside from Earth, and, well, to be fair, the tanks with lots of elemental resistance tend to be less sturdy to compensate anyways. In terms of stats, building her is surprisingly easy, especially once you get her Super Trustmaster reward, which lets you address her greatest weakness, a lack of elemental resistance. Additionally, there are slight differences between both forms, which could trip you up. For instance, the difference levels of elemental resistance and status ailment resistance, which you may need to address. Still, her active abilities are very strong to more than make up for this, and Maeve is an excellent unit to serve as a general tank for many different fights. Thanks for watching, and if you like this video, leave a like and subscribe. Comment below if you plan to get Maeve. Personally, I plan to run one of the Trials of Mana banners before they disappear. Maeve's a great unit, don't get me wrong, and the design's not too shabby either. But she's also non-limited, so priority goes to the collaboration instead. Here's hoping I get her off banner eventually.